Now this says parcel select U.S. postage fees paid, shipping department, Boyle Avenue, Vernon, California. So I guess this came through the shipment in California somewhere. All right, here's the instruction sheet. I love reading these. Placement 1.6 cc, cylinder diameter 13 millimeters. 13 millimeters is like what, a half inch? Just over, just a shade over half an inch. So the first thing I'm seeing here is a starter rope. It's not even a foot long. It's 10 inches long. There's a little thing here. That's, I'm assuming, I think that might be for the drill to get it started. It's got some nice foam. Voila, there it is. Model airplane engine style, carburetor, exhaust. It doesn't blow exhaust in your face while you're trying to start it. It's got an on-off switch. Not a great deal of compression. All right, this is the some fuel I found. I had some leftover true fuel. Just comes from Lowe's or something, but I think they have a gimmick on those. All the little chainsaws, weed eaters, leaf blowers, and you have to buy this fuel because if you run car gas in them, the fuel line gets stiff, rotten, and cracks in the plastic and the carburetor and stuff. Stiff, rotten, cracks, and it ruins your weed eater. But you know, it's like a gimmick. There's fuel line that gasoline doesn't attack. It's been around for years. They could put it in those engines if they wanted to. But this fuel right here doesn't cost $2.60 a gallon. It costs $19 a gallon. So that's why I only bought a quart. They're forcing you to use their own fuel so they can sell it to you at a 400% markup or whatever it is. Ridiculous. Anyway, that's what I'm going to use. I usually use Walmart camp fuel, which is equivalent, I think, to Coleman's stove fuel, white gas. Have you noticed batteries lately? Price has gone out of sight on these. Anyway, four little batteries, $5.79. Crazy, in my opinion. All right, so I'm going to put the batteries in it. I'll mix up a little batch of fuel. I got to find something to. Like, it's gonna have a microscopic funnel. This hole is less than a quarter of an inch in diameter. So I found a nice little funnel. Just to give you the size of this engine. That funnel is like too big. This engine is tiny. That's part of the appeal of it, right? It's really tiny, really cool. A little bit of oil. This is just, it's just 30 weight oil. Just a little bit in here, tiny bit, because the gas tank's not very big. Probably too much. Thin that with a little WD-40. And then the fuel. Volts. Try something else. Well, it went somewhere. This is stock out of the box. That's it. What you saw me do, I put the batteries in it. Some gas, and let's see what happens. Spark on, spark ignition is now on. Let's just see what happens here. this is going to be a pain because you have to hold the engine. So the ignition is on. I'm going to choke it. I don't think it has a lot of compression. So I choked it on that one. It's wide open. This is, all right, forget this. I'm going to use the little drill attachment thing they gave me. Switch on. Pretty good. Pretty good for the... So, that was pretty fun. I'm going to open the needle up just to hear, try it again. little bit of it. That's it. That's low throttle. That's it.